Right, I think we can start now. Assalamu alaikum, everyone. I hope that you are all fine and safe. So today, inshallah, we are going to start officially our course contents for the Physics 102 course. And we will start from the first part of electrostatics, which is related to chapter 21 in the textbook of University Physics and Mastering Physics. This chapter will be covered, inshallah, over the upcoming three to four lectures to cover the topics of electric charges, electrostatic forces, electric field, and we will cover both theoretical basics and problem solving, inshallah. So, what are the goals that we need to understand by the end of this chapter? As shown to you, that we need to understand what are the electric charges, اللي هي الشحنات الكهربية يا شباب, اللي هي positive and negative. What is the origin of these charges? How to make objects to be electrostatically charged? يعني ازاي اجي اشحن جسم واخليه نوع عليه شحنات positive او شحنات negative. And also to know the conservation of electric charge concept, اللي هو قانون حفظ الشحنات, like the conservation of energy. Okay, then we will move to know how the charges are interacted to each other. What is the electrostatic force, which is called Coulomb's force, between different charges? Then we will understand the concept of electric field, اللي هو المجال الكهربي, which is surrounding to the charges, اللي هو بيبقى محيط بالcharges, and the concept of electric field lines as an analogy to magnetic field lines. If you remember from the high school level, we know that there is magnetic field and magnetic field lines, اللي هو المجال المغناطيسي وخطوط المجال المغناطيسي. So we will know a similar concept to what we already know from the magnetism, but this time we will apply it for electricity. Okay? Then we will move to the relation between electric force and electric field and to see the properties of electric charge distributions. Okay, so let's start today understand theoretically the charges, how the objects could be charged, and the conservation of charges. So as an introduction, the charges or the interaction between the charges are essential and vital in our daily life applications. يعني في كل حاجة في حياتنا تقريبا بنلاقي ان في تأثير متبادل للشحنات. For example, like this photo of one athlete who's thirsty and drinking water. The drinking process itself, or how our objects or how our bodies are absorbing water, it's essentially related to electrostatic charges. So for example, all of you know from the high school level that the molecules of water, اللي هي جزيئات المية, اللي هي H2O, are composed of H positive and OH negative. So we have ions positive and ions negative, اللي هو الهيدروجين ions positive and the hydroxyl negative ions. These ions are absorbed by our cells. الخلايا بتاع جسمنا هي اللي بتمتص الايونز دي electrostatically. So for example, the cells with negative charges, they are absorbing the H positive. The cells with dominant positive charges, they are absorbing the negative ions. تعرفين ان البوزيتيف والنيجاتيف في ما بينهم attraction او تجاذب. It's like north and south in magnetism. So let's write together some words that we may need. So here between positive and negative, I will write it in the right side of the slide. Between positive and negative, we are saying the word attraction or attract, بالعربي اللي هو التجاذب, or to be closer to each other. However, if I have same poles, positive positive together or negative negative together, then there will be what we call it repulsion, or the charges repel each other. اللي هي بالعربي اسمها التنافر. Okay, so it depends on electrostatic attraction. The word static means that the charges are not moving. So initially the charges are fixed, but they are slightly shifted related to attraction or repulsion. But it's not electric current. خدوا بالكم يا شباب من الحتة دي. معظمكم أخذ الكورس بتاع الـ EE101 which is related to electric current and circuits, and maybe you took other courses like electronics and so on, and we were depending on electric current أو التيار الكهربي in conductors or in semiconductors. No, here we are still talking about the effect of static charges. So they are not moving with drift velocity, or they are not making electric current and so on. We are talking about if they are static, then if you have positive and negative, then they will try to attract each other. If you have positive positive or negative negative similar poles, then most likely they will repel each other. أو إن هما بيتنافروا مع بعض. Okay. So here we have an important topic to talk about, which is how to charge objects. يعني لو أنا عندي ألم مثلا أو عندي رد like what's shown here in this figure. I have two rods, for example, and initially they are neutral. This is another word that we need to know. Neutral means not positive, not negative. اللي بالعربي يا شباب اسمها المتعادل. Okay, so neutral means it's not positive, dominantly positive or dominantly negative. يعني ما فيش أغلبية للpositive or to the negative. Okay, so if I have these two plastic rods and they are initially neutral, not charged, not dominantly positive or either negative, and we need to know how to charge these two rods. How to charge it? There are different techniques of charging, أو الشحن يعني, اللي هو الشحن الكهربي أو إن أنت تشحن جسم by charges. There are different methods, but for simplicity, I will mention here only one simple method, which is the induction or the friction with some naturally charged objects. What does it mean? Here, guys, look at this schematic. Through this rectangle, you will find here that we have a material of fur or wool. اللي هي زي الصوف يا شباب أو الفرير. خلاص؟ الفر أو الوول اللي هو زي الصوف, most of the fur are naturally charged by negative charges. Okay? So here, if we have an interaction or friction, احتكاك, لو أنت هتيجي تدعك أو تعمل احتكاك between these rods, plastic rods, and the fur, then some of the negative charges originally found on the fur due to its nature, then some of them will be moved or shifted or gained by the surface of these plastic rods. So consequently, these two rods are or will repel to each other. لأن الاثنين rods, these two rods becomes now negative, and we know that the same charges will repel each other. يعني هيحصل تنافر ما بين. So this is a very simple way to charge some objects, which mainly depends on the interaction between the objects and some naturally charged materials. إن في بعض المواد ربنا سبحانه وتعالى خلقها اللي بالذات اللي بيبقى فيها نوع من الشعرة أو بيبقى فيها نوع من البروتينز معينة بتبقى most mostly it's by its nature, it's dominantly charged. So this is an example like the fur. There is another example of materials which are positively charged, which is the silk. Silk, يا شباب, أو silk proteins, اللي هو بالعربي اللي هو الحرير. Okay? الحرير أو silk, mostly, most of the proteins of silk, whatever proteins generated by, زي مثلا دودة الأز أو مثلا العناكب spiders, you will find that most of these proteins are naturally statically positive. So whenever you have these two rods connected or in direct contact or in direct touch with the silk and you started rubbering them, اللي هو تعمل نوع من الاحتكاك, rubbering, okay, then you will find both rods becomes positive. And again, positive and positive will repel each other, and you will find that this rod would like to be quite far from the first rod. Okay, so you will find in the textbook some other techniques to make charging of objects. يعني مش دي التكنيكس الوحيدة شباب, طبعا في تكنيكس ياما. Okay, but I explain for you one simple technique so that we know the concept. Simply how to charge some objects. Okay, so if you have two rods, but one rod is charged by fur, so it becomes negative, and another rod is charged by silk or our hair, for example, and becomes mostly positive. Therefore, the positive and negative will attract each other, okay? Because both charges are opposite, in the الشحنات عكس بعض اللي هو الموجب والسالب, then they prefer to attract each other or to come closer to each other. And this is an example for attraction between electrostatic charges. I'm reminding guys, all of you, that we are not talking about electric current anymore. We are not talking about electric current and voltage. Of course, there will be voltage or potential, but there is no current in ampere. وإن أنا هتلسع بالتيار الكهربي ودايرة مقفولة, closed circuit. No, no, no. We are talking about static charges. When experimentally to see these static charges, تعالوا أكلمكم على some situations that you may find these static charges. Some of us, especially the ladies, who are storing coats of wool or of fur, اللي عندهم مثلا بيبقى معطف او جاكيت مثلا صوف شويه, بالذات لما بتعمل له ستورج في كابورد, and especially in dry cold weather, يعني في موجات الصقيع اللي جات لنا هنا في الكويت شهر ديسمبر وفي يناير, احيانا لما تيجي تفتح الدولاب تيجي تشوف المعطف اللي هو الوول or fur, you may hear some small sparks, تسمع كده شوية تكتكة, يعني تسمع تك تك حاجات بسيطة جدا. Okay, these are coming from the electrostatic charges by nature, which are accumulated, اللي هي بتتراكم, on the wool or the fur, and these charges are acting together, especially in cold weather. يعني بالذات في الكولد weather يا شباب, نلاقي ان الستاتيك تشارجز بيبقى عندها فرصه اكبر to be accumulated on surfaces. Some people are feeling the electrostatics or electrostatic charges, and I'm one of them, especially in cold weather, when you are holding metal parts suddenly. يعني اللي مننا يا شباب بيمسك مثلا مقبض باب وهو داخل كافيه مثلا, او بيمسك مقبض باب معدن وهو بيفتح عربيته, بيمسك الباب المعدن مثلا من الاطراف. Especially in the cold weather, you may feel some little bit shock. تحس ان انت اتكهربت كده. وبعدين ترجع تمسك تاني ما تلاقيش حاجه. يعني هي بس just one shot during the first contact. Why that happened? Due to the accumulation of electrostatic charges on sharp edges of metals, especially in the dry, cold weather. تمام؟ فدي بتحصل لناس كتير وأنا منهم، إن لما ساعات بمسك مقبض معدن أو كده أحس إن أنا بتكهرب لأول مرة وبعدين أمسكه تاني مفيش حاجة. عشان كده حتى نفضل الناس اللي بتعاني من الموضوع ده، we prefer to hold non-metallic parts، لأن non-metallic parts بيبقى فرص تكوين اللي charges عليها وإن هي تبقى ساكنة و accumulated بتبقى فرص ضعيفة نسبيا. فمثلا لو أنت عايز تفتح باب مثلا، يفضل إن أنت تمسك الجزء الإزاز مثلا، not to hold the metallic part or you may be charged suddenly or you feel very little tiny electric shock. Okay. فالتشارجز يا شباب دي بتبقى موجودة في حياتنا بشكل كبير جدا وبنشوفها باستمرار. تعالوا أشرح لكم برضو، let's explain one very interesting game that we were playing during we were kids. If I have a comb اللي هي فرشة شعر or even a pen، لو حتى pen، ساعات كنا بنعمل ايه يا شباب؟ بنعمل rubbering in our hair، يعني بنعمل contact بالhair، our hair، and our hair by nature it's mostly statically charged. Okay, so for example if we have negative charges on our hair then by rubbering اللي هو بطريقة الدعكة أو بطريقة الاحتكاك المستمر then some of these negative charges will be accumulated on the surface of the comb or the pen اللي هو فرشة شعر أو البن. Then if you cut pieces of paper in very small pieces then there might be holding for some pieces and then you can raise the pen which is holding pieces of small pieces of paper. ما عارفش اذا كنتوا عملتوا اللعبه دي قبل كده ولا لا، لكن دي كانت مشهوره جدا واحنا اولاد صغيرين، ان ممكن نرفع some small pieces of papers using pen or comb. The explanation, the physical explanation of that guys, that whenever you are rubbering in your hair, as I said, then the object, whatever the comb or pen, is holding negative charges, for example. The pieces of paper, guys, are neutral by its nature. هي متعادلة. يعني the piece of paper مفروض فيها negative, positive, but neutral and equally distributed. يعني متوزعين بانتظام على سطح البيبر. But if you are get the pen or the comb closer to this paper, what will happen for these charges? You will find that these charges will be redistributed, يعني يعاد توزيعها, so that the positive will be closer to the negative of the pen, and the negative will be far or more far from the pen. يبقى كأن البوستيف والنيجاتيف بيقربوا من بعض، أو البوستيف اللي هو في البيبر got closer to the negative of the pen. Okay. Yes, Abdullah, you are right. You can find a lot of applications depending on the electrostatics interaction. You are right. So here you will find that the positive becomes closer to negative of the paper, and the negative becomes quite shifted from the negative of pen. يعني بيحصل attraction للpositive ويحصل repulsion للnegative. Then this electrostatic force اللي هو التجاذب, F attraction, may be in some cases greater than mg of the paper. يبقى طالما ال F attraction أكبر من وزن الورقة, عشان كده بنقطعها حتت صغيرة عشان يبقى وزنها صغير جدا, وبالتالي then this paper may be on hold and raised up. Okay, so this is a quick example about the electrostatic interaction between the charges. Okay, so the simplest way to charge an object is to make it in contact with some materials which are naturally or by its nature it's already statically charged, as I said, like your hair, fur, wool, or silk, for example. Okay, So till this point, guys, before we continue, do you have any question or concern till now? Okay, let's continue to know some details about the charges itself. From where we can find charges, whatever positive or negative. And this is not new information for any of us, that the main positive and negative are coming from atoms, okay, our zarat. You all know that the atom has very little tiny nucleus, in the center of the atom. This nucleus is filled or compacted with positive protons, and neutral neutrons. في بروتونات موجبة ونيوترونز متعادلة. Okay? So most of the nucleus or the nucleus itself is positive, but to let you know that most of the mass of the atom is concentrated in the nucleus. Or in another way, that both protons and neutrons are very heavy compared to the electrons or the remaining mass of the atom, okay? So the nucleus is positive. The mass of protons or neutrons are much larger compared to the neutrons. So most of the nucleus, most of the atom mass is concentrated in the nucleus, okay? All right, so what about the electrons? The electrons are negative. They are rotating around the nucleus in orbital, most likely it's elliptical, not circular. احنا للتسهيل احنا بنقول ان هي في مدارات دائرية, but the real situation is that these orbital or subshells are quite elliptical. بتبقى over شوية by the way شوية. المهم ان these electrons are occupying the volume of the atom. يعني حجم الاتوم بالكامل مليء بالالكترونز. لكن الماس هي اللي concentrated in the little tiny nucleus. Okay? But the volume of atom اللي هو حجم الاتوم الكبير ده بيبقى مليان جدا بالالكترونز. Okay? So, the main nature of the atom should be neutral. يعني العادي بتاع الاتومز انها تبقى متعادله او نيوترال, which means that the total positive equal to total negative. يبقى total positive charges are equal to total negative charges. So let me explain the following example on the whiteboard, and it's mentioned in the slides, but I prefer to show it on the whiteboard. For example, for one famous element, lithium 3-7. Atomic number 3, mass number 7. اللي هو العدد الذري 3, العدد الكتلي 7. Lithium is very important in the fabrication of batteries or the battery industry. Lithium مستخدم كتير جدا في الباتريز. في الباتريز. المهم ان lithium 3-7, what does it mean 3-7? That by its nature, it has 3 protons positive, and consequently 3 electrons negative are rotating around the nucleus, and 7 minus 3 equal 4 neutrons. يبقى في 4 neutrons, but we will not focus on the neutrons in our current discussion because we focus only on positive and negative charges. So initially we have 3 protons in the nucleus, and around them, there are 3 rotating electrons. And by nature, it's mainly neutral. يعني متعادلة كهربيا في البداية خالص. Okay? What about if we made excitation for this atom? What does it mean by excitation? It means that you are giving this atom some sort of energy. Most likely this energy will be coming from light, يعني ان انا انزل لايت مثلا يو في او فايلوت وات ايفر اكوردنج تو ذا الكترون الكترون ستيت اند ذا ماتيريال اند سو اون بات موست لايكلي ات وود بي لايت بات اولسو يو مي ابلاي اكسايتيشن باي هيت باي ميكانيكال انرجي ثيرمال انرجي اور هيت maybe electric field, maybe magnetic field, and so on. So whatever the source of excitation, if this excitation is enough to free one electron, يعني نلاقي إن three protons زي ما هم, two electrons زي ما هم, but the third electron becomes free, لأنه مرتبط ببينding energy, طاقة ربط with the atom, if you gave this electron the same value at least of the energy, then this energy or this electron will be removed or released from the atom. Okay, then in this case the material lost one, or the atom lost one electron, so it becomes positive three protons but unfortunately only two electrons. Then the positive becomes larger than negative, and this is what we call it, positive ion. So the atom becomes called ion, اللي هو ion موجب أو حصل للأتوم التأيون or ionization, which means here that the charges become not neutral anymore. Okay? This electron, the free electron, maybe by coincidence or by certain processes, it may be gained by another atom. يعني يبقى في atom تانية, lithium, it will gain this electron. Okay, so this electron will be transferred from an atom to another atom. Then this new atom will have this time four electrons, but still having only three positive protons. So the number of electrons becomes larger than number of protons, and consequently this atom becomes negatively ionized or negative ion. Okay? So now this atom becomes negatively ionized. Okay? So now we know how to make an atom to be positive or negative compared to its original state of being neutral. Okay, so here it's positive if the protons becomes larger than electrons, or you are losing electrons. If you are gaining electrons, then negative will be larger than positive, and consequently it becomes negative ion. So this information that I explained on the whiteboard already mentioned here through the example of lithium. So here it's originally neutral atom, total positive equal to total negative. Then it becomes positive ion if you are releasing one electron through an excitation, or it becomes a negative ion if you gained one electron extra, and then the number of electrons becomes larger than number of protons. Okay, so let's move to the last part of our lecture today. Our lecture today is mainly theoretical basics, and inshallah starting from next lecture on Sunday, inshallah we will start showing for you some more rules and some more examples to solve it together. So we have a very important concept we need to understand it, which is the conservation of charge, اللي هي قانون بقاء الشحنات. It's similar to the concept of conservation of energy. What is the conservation of energy? That the energy is any closed system will not be wasted. It could be transformed from a form to another. يعني مثلا يبقى عندي kinetic energy or potential energy, شوية ده يزيد شوية ده يقل, يبقى في trade off between both states. But given that in a closed system without any losses of energy, like friction for example, لو تفتكروا من الفيزيكس 101, that the total energy would be conserved. يعني total kinetic energy plus potential energy will be equal. We need to apply the same concept for the charges. So let's read these three points together. The first point is that the proton and the electron both have the same magnitude of charge. What does it mean? It means that the charge of proton equal positive 1.6 times 10 power negative 19, and the unit is coulomb. The standard units of the charges is called coulomb as an appreciation for the scientist coulomb, who had a very useful contribution to the concept of the charges, whatever theoretically based or experimental based also, okay? And the charge has a symbol of Q, whatever Q small or Q capital. هتلاقوا دايما يا شباب كلمة charge دي نعبر عنها بالletter اللي هو Q, whatever Q capital or Q small, and the standard units is in coulomb. So the amount of a charge of one proton, 1.6 times 10 power negative 19 coulomb, and it has an experiment to verify this charge. The charge of electron will be negative as well, but it has the same magnitude. It would be minus 1.6 times 10 power negative 19 coulomb also. So as a summary, that the charge of proton as a magnitude equal to the charge of electron as a magnitude. And then if for any atom, not ion, for any atom, the total number of proton equal to the total number of electron, then the total positive charge equal to the total negative charge, and hence it's considered as neutral atom. فالعادي يا شباب حتى لو أنا عندي simplest atom like hydrogen مثلا, الهيدروجين اللي هو H11 اللي هو فيه 1 electron, 1 proton, 0 neutron, you will find that the hydrogen generally, if it's not ionized, it's neutral because the 1 proton equal as a charge to the 1 electron, okay? So this is the first point that we need to know. Here, guys, there is an important point to know, that take care that this is the simplest charge that we know. This is the simplest unit of a charge. So you will not find half electron, half proton, quarter proton. ما فيش حاجة اسمها fraction of the charge unit. So the charge unit or the minimum charge that you may find ever is either proton or electron. This is what we called in the second sentence, that the charges are quantized. يعني إيه quantized؟ يعني takes specific quantities, تاخد كميات محددة. يعني مثلا, let me remove all of that. If we have, for example, one ball, and I need to charge it with some electrons. So I may find on this ball one electron, two electrons, three, four, and so on. So I definitely will have number integer number of charges, electrons or protons. Okay, so here, the number of charges on any charged object must be integer. لازم يكون عدد صحيح يا شباب. ولا ينفع يبقى fraction, ولا ينفع يبقى مثلا 1.5, 2.3, ما ينفعش. It must be an integer. Okay? So now we can know the first rule of this concept, that the total charge on any object, let's call it Q capital, is integer number of the small charge of electron or proton. So n here is an integer number اللي هو عدد صحيح. Okay. يبقى لو عندي كورة عايز أشحنها بإلكترونز يبقى إما تتشحن بوان إلكترون or two electrons, three electrons and so on. Then the total charge will be one electron or two electrons or three electrons and so on. Okay. So this is a very important rule that the total charge on any object must be an integer number of or integer multiplications of the charge of electron or proton. من غير دلوقتي يا شباب احنا تعلمنا حاجتين ان البروتون اور الكترون ار ايكوال تو ايتش اذر ان ماجنيتيود. الحاجه الثانيه ان this electron or proton charges are the minimum or the main unit of the charge and it cannot be fractions. وبالتالي يبقى الobservable charges are quantized or integer number of such charges, whatever electrons or protons. Okay. الحاجة الثالثة المهمة جدا جدا اللي هي the universal principle of charge conservation. بس قبل ما أقول لكم الconcept ده حابب بس أوضح لكم برضو حاجة عشان تبقوا عارفين يعني معلومات أكتر. There may be some particles may have fractions of the charges of electrons or protons. يعني في عندها charges كتير عندها particles كتير حاجة اسمها muons, mesons and so on. بس دول the charges دول يا شباب أو the particles دول يا شباب have what we call it lifetime. ليهم فترة عمر and then they disappear in nanosecond, microsecond, femtosecond. They are disappeared and converted into energy. يعني هي بتختفي بسرعة البارتكلز دي not stable تمام but here we focus on the more stable particles يعني الالكترونز والبروتونز are very stable and they are lasting for many years without being decayed or being transformed into energy خلاص فعشان بس تبقوا عارفين ان في حاجات تانية غير الالكترونز والبروتونز وممكن يبقى التشارجز بتاعتهم fractional لكن الحاجات دي نون ستيبل فعشان كده ما بناخدهاش في اعتبارنا في الكورس اللي هو بتاع الفيزيكس 102 and these particles are related to a higher advanced level of physics courses called modern physics تمام لكن احنا بالنسبه لنا اصغر تشارجز نعرفها اللي هي الستيبل الكترونز وبروتونز اوكي سو ذس از جاست فور يور نوليدج ذا لاست بارت اوف ذا كونزرفيشن اوف ا تشارج ويتش از ذا برينسيبل of charge conservation in any closed system يعني ما يبقاش فيه losses للcharges that charges the total charges will be constant or conserved. What does it mean? Look at this example. I have two balls. First ball has 10 electrons and the second ball, for example, has zero electrons. Okay. And both are in a closed system. يعني عامل عليهم isolation in the charges will not be escaped from this rectangular system. Okay. What happened, guys, if I made a contact between these two balls? لو أنا جبت حتة معدن كده, تلك معدن, between these two balls, then some of the 10 electrons will be moving to the second ball and then these two spheres for example the first sphere becomes having six electrons and the second one will have for example four electrons after being connected okay then the conservation of a charge says that the total number of charges whatever in the first case before being contacted or second case after being contacted both systems will have the same total number of charges يعني الاولاني يا شباب في 10 electrons الثاني برضه هيبقى التوتال فيه كام 6 plus 4 equal 10 electrons بالظبط يا بيبي مظبوط so here the total number whatever بقى ال 10 دي اتوزعت ازاي 6 and 4 7 3 8 2 the total will be the same 10 electrons. I know that some of you might think about why I mentioned 6 and 4. مفروض ان انا كنت اقول 5 and 5 انهم توزعوا بانتظام. Take care, you will know by the time that it's not necessarily to have equal distribution. It depends on the type of materials. يعني تفرق جدا نوع الماتيريالز بتاع الكورتين and the size of each ball. يعني لو كانوا two balls are of the same material and same size, the answer is yes, both will take 5 electrons. إنهم هيتساووا. But if the two balls are not on, of the same size, يعني واحدة كبيرة واحدة صغيرة في الحجم, or this material aluminum, this material is copper, this material is plastic, this material is wood, for example, then not necessarily to have equal distribution, okay? But don't worry of this point. This is not our point for now, guys. هي مش دي نقطتنا اللي احنا بنتكلم فيها. احنا النقطة اللي بنتكلم فيها ان total number of charges will be equal whatever for the first system or for the second system, okay? Before we end our lecture for today, we will stop by this limit and inshallah we will continue on the upcoming Sunday lecture. But before we continue, guys, do you have any question or inquiries in today's contents of the lecture?
No, doctor, thank you.
All right, so Abdullah, تفضل.
دكتور انا ما عندي سؤال بخصوص الكلاس بس عندي سؤال بخصوص البرنامج اللي ندرس فيه الواجبات
الماستر اوكي
متى راح تدز لنا اللينك عشان
most likely النهارده ان شاء الله اخر اليوم او بالكثير يوم الاحد ان شاء الله بس هحاول النهارده ان انا هرفع لكم الفايل اللي هو how to move step by step on the procedure of registering in Master in Physics. فما تقلقش. ولسه بدري يا شباب على أول homework. أنا مش هديكوا homework سريع الأسبوع اللي جاي أو حتى اللي بعديه. يعني هناخد شوية وقت بحيث يعني تبقوا معاكوا الأكسس للماستر إن فيزيكس تبقوا مؤهلين تماماً وبعدين نبقى ندي الأول homework يعني. فما تقلقش. إن شاء الله النهاردة أو يوم الأحد بالكثير هيبقى الفايل ده موجود على المودل إن شاء الله. أوكي؟
تمام يا دكتور يعطيك العافية.
ها شباب في أي أسئلة تانية؟ تمام نشوفكم على خير إن شاء الله في محاضرة يوم الأحد الجاي إن شاء الله. السلام عليكم.